The delegation from the Uganda Communications Commission, led by the Director in Charge of Technology, Patrick Mwesije, called for the harmonization of the provisions of the Anti-Pornography Bill 2011 that already appear in the Uganda Communications Act 2013. Mwesige said this would prevent duplicity.
So there's a need to harmonize the provisions of this bill with those in the Communications Act to avoid any possible areas of conflict. And we have pointed out specific definitions and other provisions which need to be harmonized between the bill and the existing Communications Act.
The Commission also said the definition of pornography in the bill was too broad and failed to explain other issues like sexual activities, sexual parts, erotic behavior intended to cause sexual excitement, and indecent acts or behavior tending to corrupt morals.
Points out cultural practices as constituting pornography, and that is not true. If you attempt to attack the cultural practices of societies in Uganda, you will be going overboard with this bill.
The UCC's submission immediately sparked off an argument on its merits, as others pointed out that it could not control people using internet and it would criminalize cultural attires deemed sexually provocative.
So Mr. Chairperson, sometimes people should not take this committee for a ride, because at the end of the day, we shall be like what my former colleague Honorable Namayanja is saying. We shall be the people to be ashamed on the floor of Parliament. Whoever thinks of a low idea, thinks of making a bill, comes here and uses us as a playground. Really, we should not allow this. This bill is not called for.
You are aware that we have done a lot. This committee has done a lot. And the embarrassment that we got on the floor of Parliament, already three bills are collapsing on the floor of Parliament. And this one is going to follow suit, because from what I can see, it seems the ministers who are introducing these bills are bringing up raw data.
The bill also seeks to outlaw miniskirts and spells out a hefty fine or jail term for offenders.